Hey, what is going on, guys? Bringing you a special kind of video, bringing you the division guide. And this guide is just how to start and how to play the game. So first off, let's start with the base of operations. This base is where everything happens. This base is where you get your special abilities, such as your right shield, your vision pulse, everything, pretty much your special abilities. And you could actually upgrade those abilities. I'll speak about that later on. But yeah, what you need to do is upgrade the wings, the medical wing, the technical wing, and the security wing, which is the third one. And you also have your ammo box for whenever you leave the base of operations. This is just for the campaign mode of the game. There is a PvP area. This is the map. This is where you start. You start at Camp Hudson. This is where you pretty much get introduced to the game, so you get dropped off in the beginning. So from the looks of it, the map is pretty humongous. You do the main missions, the side missions for the campaign mode area, but this is the first mission right here, the medical wing mission. This is how you unlock the medical wing, and this is how you lock the technical wing for the second mission. But this is the whole dark zone area. This whole thing, we didn't have the whole thing in the beta, but it will be available in the game release, you know. And this area also right here is probably part of the game, and this other side also. So you know the map is going to be pretty huge. This map is going to be amazing when the game comes out. It's mostly going to be mostly going to be made of the campaign. The campaign is very important, guys. Don't ignore the campaign just because the dark zone is awesome as hell. The campaign is very important to the game. The game all is made up of your abilities and how to use them. Also how to upgrade your weapons. Like, so you can see I have the Liberator on right now, which is one of the high-end weapons. I did end up getting both, but we'll get into that into the end of the video. But each armor, each attachment, each equipment that you put onto your character actually fixes their DPS and their health and skill power, which is very important, guys. Don't ignore that. Just because an armor is like level 61, level 60 could actually even be better than 61. Your DPS is important. As you can see, that my DPS would go up, but my health would go down. And that's okay with me. You know, the DPS is very important when you're shooting someone. Just try to even it out between your health and your DPS. So choose your armors wisely. Choose your equipment wisely, your weapons. Any attachment that you add on to your weapons, your mods, and everything is very important. And this is the special abilities. You could actually modify these special abilities into way better ones. I used the third one, which actually adds extra damage to the characters or enemies that you pretty much scan with your pulse. The health would be very important also. The health is something you could use to heal yourself instead of carrying medkits all the time. I always use it. I use only these two specific perks. I could not unlock anything else because it's not part of the beta. I did try to do my best to unlock everything that I could, and I actually did. I had nothing left, so this is pretty much it until the real game comes out. So when it comes to your weapons, actually this is not your weapons, but you could actually change your character's appearance. You just go to your start menu all the way to the right to appearance, and usually these items you get it from people that you helped or the people in the dark zone that you killed. The CPUs is what I'm talking about. You actually pick them up, you extract them, and then you get to wear it. So the dark zone, let's get into the dark zone. The dark zone is the PvP area. There are CPUs in there. Those guys are really annoying, but you have no means to pay any attention to them. You can level them up. So what you need to do in the dark zone, pretty much you either take down some rogue agents, which is what I'm going to do here. And once you take down rogue agents, you actually do get dark zone funds and you do level up. Taking down a dark zone rogue agent actually levels you up pretty quickly. It does give you a lot of XP for doing it. As you can see, look at my XP going up, skyrocketing pretty much. The higher the rogue level agent is, the more XP that you get. I pretty much just took all three of them out by myself, which is awesome, guys. But also, you can go rogue. And you're probably like, why do I want to go rogue, Mugs? Like, why do I even want to do that? That's just a risky situation that I do not want to take on. Well, you guys, the reason you want to go rogue is the longer you last rogue, the higher level you are, Rogue, you actually gain more XP for it. As you can see, I'm about to, me and one of my friends are about to take these guys out. We actually do take all of them out. It's freaking amazing. Look at this. Almost there. Our names just pop out like crazy. Look at that, guys. Boom, boom. We just took all these guys out. We kept taking them out and taking them out. This guy's going to go down. No, actually, yeah, he managed to run away. I'm sorry. But, you know, being rogue is awesome, too. It's also fun. I really enjoy going rogue most of my time. If I do see a rogue agent, I will take him out. And this clip, you know, pretty much how to get rid of rogue is you got to let the countdown go off. Somebody did try chasing me down. This is really hilarious. This guy did not know that I, like, broke his ankles pretty much. Just watch this. He actually comes up the stairs. I go down the stairs, letting him think that I'm still up there, and let my countdown go pretty much down. If you're next to a rogue agent, the countdown won't go down. But the further I get away, my rogue agents go down. And once your rogue countdown goes down, you know you're not rogue anymore. But the main missions to doing the Dark Zone from the beta was to get these two guns, was the Pack Can and the Liberator. The Liberator and the Pack Can are amazing weapons. You get them at the Dark Zone vendor in the safety house. But that's pretty much it, you guys. That's pretty much all you need to do. Pretty much in the Dark Zone, just be sure to have the high DPS, your high health, the right weapons, the right attachments to make your DPS even go higher. And don't underestimate the Pack Can, bros. The Pack Can is the most amazing weapon. So until next time, you guys, peace and keep on gaming, bros.